is a tag response to Bel Air Scents. And the topic of today's video is to talk about leather fragrances in my collection.
I got my sign on.
Gotta do my thing. Gotta do my thing. Gotta do my thing. Gotta do my thing. Okay.
Every single day, I'm gonna make something great. That's my way. Every single day, I'm gonna make something great. That's my way.
What's going on YouTube? Welcome back to the Uncommon Scents Family Clan. If you're new to the channel, take a look around, and once you've decided that this is the place that you should be, I want you to do all three. We want to make sure we like, comment, and subscribe. And I'm very thankful and grateful to have you guys back with me one more time. This is a tag response to Bel Air Scents. Tag me in something, and I'm down for it, I'm down for it. Man of my word. Today's video is to talk about leather fragrances in my life. I struggled for a second to figure out.
Okay, I'm gonna do a top 10, a top 15. How should I organize it? What should be on it?
And I just figured, you know what? I'm gonna take it easy. This is gonna be fun. It's gonna be relaxed. But it's gonna be hype at the same time, right? Right. I'm gonna talk about the leather fragrances I have in my collection. I have two generous decants of Tom Ford fragrances that are leather forward. One is very leather forward. It's a little bitter. Almond. A lot of people say it has a burnt tire or burnt rubber kind of note, which I do get that. It's much better on the dry down. It is a fragrance that is niche-ish. It's harder to wear. The next one is ombre leather. I've worn this one considerably more, but this one holds a special place in my heart because I wore it to my second graduation. And I wore it in California heat. It was everything. I enjoyed this. I wore it on the Hollywood Boulevard Strip. I love how leather is done like this. I love the mix of the fruit with the leather. I'm in the place of practicality. Until I finish this, I'm not gonna make a decision on if I'm gonna get full bottles of it. Somewhat of honorable mentions for Tom Ford's fabulous and ombre leather. The next semi-honorable mention I have, Mirameta La Leva, which lists lemon, leather, and vanilla. Ugh, the leather in this one is a little bit more sharp. I kind of feel like it's probably a more saddle leather, one of those rougher leathers that, you know, of a good duffel bag that'll last you for forever. It's so sweet and fresh. I got quite a few people to thank for putting me onto this one. Dan from St. Waters is one. He reviewed this like forever ago. Two, Lamar Gatson told me that I should definitely get it. Sam Broome as well told me I should definitely give it a shot. And it's got a dessert leather type of feel. Another solid option to have for a leather lover. But it mixes the gourmand essence, which I absolutely adore. Last but not least for the honorable mention section is going to be a fragrance I've had in my collection. I finally finished it. Tears, real tears. Rest in peace to this fragrance because the fragrance line has been discontinued. I talk about it quite often. I'm pretty sure you guys are sick of hearing about it, but I don't care. I'm gonna talk about it because it's my channel and I'm gonna miss it. It's gone. It's done. It was boozy and leathery, and it was so gentle. Find a Fendi from. It's out of there, y'all. I had to give it a little bit of honorable mention and a proper send-off. As I was doing my research and preparing for this video, I found out that this fragrance has leather in it. I don't smell much leather in the fragrance, but it's listed in the notes. And it's made by one of my favorite perfumers, Alberto Maria's. So shout out to Alberto Maria's. Aqua Form. A lot of people say this is similar to Polo Sport. I do get that. It's a freshie, banging atomizer. But it's very fresh. It's kind of one of those shower gel fragrances. It's mass appealing. I don't think anybody would be upset that you smell clean and fresh and masculine. That's Aqua Porn. Next up, a new one to my collection. That's going to be John Bravado's Dark Rebel Rider. Dope. Presentation. Love that. Love the fleur de lis. These are legit functional zippers. Cute, a little sexy music, like you stripping, you strip it down, and then a little top down action. Woohoo! A little flash, you know how we do. Zip it back up. This fragrance is extremely affordable. I may have paid $25 for a 4.2 ounce. I think it's huge. I want to thank Paige of Stylez for enabling us and letting us know about this fragrance, because I've seen it around. I hadn't had much interest in it, but I wanted to give it a shot. All I really get is like leather with a faint note of amber. So up front, it's like leather, like leather jacket. Walking into Wilson's leather store, leather, just in your face, leather. It kind of comes off, it's a little bit badassy, which I kind of like. The amber is very subdued in the background. I've been seeing a little bit about this one not having the best performance, but with having 4.2 ounces, I can just put in decant and respray. But also too, when I think about it, would I want to smell like this all day? Probably not. It's actually kind of good that this one does not last as long as probably some of my other fragrances that I'm going to present, because I don't want to just smell like leather and amber. Like, I like a multifaceted fragrance. I like a fragrance that takes me on a journey. And this one doesn't necessarily do that. It kind of gives you leather, amber. That's it. Next up, we got Halloween Man X. A little newer to my collection. I had a sample, Lamar Gatson. He's an enabler. Y'all watch out for Lamar Gatson. Shout out to you, bro. Thank you very much. He sent me a sample of it a little early in the summer, and I didn't care for it in the summertime. Admittedly, I didn't give it a wearing in winter. We hadn't gotten to fall and cooler temperatures yet. So I wasn't feeling it then. I actually tried it recently, thanks to Naps and Nurture. Another enabler. Why y'all watch out for these people? These people will have you buying stuff. I started to get into it. It has what's called a blackjack accord. What I really get from this one is coffee and sweetness. The leather note is very toned down. It's leather in it, but it's not leather forward. You get me? Okay. But it has an amazing, amazing scent. And it has an amazing sprayer too. I did not need 3 sprays. I'm gonna rethink that. But it opens with a really bright sweetness that I like, but then it goes into a coffee territory. Very multifaceted, especially to not be a very expensive fragrance. Probably about $25 for 4.2 ounce. I'm like, what? Next up, Burberry London. This one made a fall list for me. Cinnamon, leather. Let's see what else we get. Some spice, leather, cinnamon. That's what I'm getting out of this one. Burberry London. Perfect for fall. Yeah, too. So when I first got it, I wasn't over the moon about it. I got it late spring or early summer. And I sprayed it on then, and that was before I really started to really take into account certain fragrances require certain seasons to really wear them. And I didn't feature it then. But as it got cooler, oh, I was like, okay, I can fuck with that. Next up, Gentleman by Givenchy. This is the 2017 release. As you guys can see, it has that flask-like presentation, really solid cap, Givenchy Gentleman. It does have a prominent note of iris. There we go. This made a spring list for me. It's very fresh, but it's very gentlemanly, and I really enjoy that it's distinguished. Iris, leather, and may have some lavender in there. Lavender, iris, leather. Lil. Lavender, iris, leather. Kind of what I get out of that. Next up, this is one that I feature on several lists. It's beast mode in my opinion. It's top 10, 10 out of 10 in my opinion. And bringing out the blues. It's made several lists. It's one of my favorites. And I'm actually glad I got a chance to experience it. The consensus in Fragcomm is that it's a sweet coy mess, but I don't give a damn about what they talking about there, because I like this one. Next up, we have Balmain Homme. Recently, I figured out that it's pronounced Balmain. So we'll acquiesce, right? I call it Balmain. We'll be cultured like I know about a little bit of fashion now. Balmain Homme. Ugh, I really dig this one. It is very sweet, and it has some strength to it. This one has a leather note, but the fragrance itself is not leather forward. It's a bit more sweet in the bubblegummy sense of the word. It lasts forever on my skin, which is very rare for me because fragrances tend to burn off of my skin kind of quick. Dope ass bottle too. Get to that presentation. And it's my favorite color, if you couldn't tell. Royal blue is my favorite shade, but blue period is my favorite color. Next up, gifted to us by Abraham Johnson. Shout out to Abraham. Ooh, blue notes. I've been pronouncing like the Canadians. There's a lot more amber, vanillic, and it does have notes of leather, which is prominent. I found a space to put it on. I'm becoming a Mancera junkie. Soon I'll have about 7 Manceras, and I never thought I would be that guy, but I'm turning into that guy. Vanillic. It's a little powdery, but it's powdery in the sense of it being sweet. It's a sweet powdery. The subtle balance of leather in the background. It's not a really loud leather, which I actually like. This one has good longevity. Nice bottle. Ain't mad at that at all. Since I've gotten it, I've been putting some wear on it. I usually wear it going to like breakfast on a Saturday. Yeah, this one's a bit more casual than most of the other fragrances that I have in terms of the niche ones. This one's a little bit more of a dumb reach in the fact that I think I can wear this anywhere. Next up, we're gonna talk about presentation, baby. Presentation. Let's get into that box. Novice Parfums Oud Luxuria. Very kingly. Royalty.
Bruh.
I love. Love presentation like this. Nice heavy bottle. Nice heavy everything. Nice heavy cap. And this one is strong. Like Hercules strong. I'm not gonna even spray it in here because it's a fragrance that once it's in the air, it's in the air. I honestly think 2 sprays of this and you are set. It's Laotian oud, leather, and some spices, if I'm not mistaken. Oh my God. Now, I usually don't like skanky, barnyardy ouds. This is one of those ones, but this is manageable. Now, to be smelling it in your face all day, that's gonna be tough. So that's why I say 2 sprays. I will probably do 2 sprays on the shoulders or across the back of my neck or something like that. I don't know if I can handle it just being in my face all the time because I sprayed it right here one time and kept smelling it and up on it, it's tough. But while it's in the air, it's very enjoyable. This is very boss man executive status. Next up, Bentley for Men Intense. Ugh, I actually really like this fragrance, I must say. It's a classy, clean, boss-ass fragrance. Something a little fougere-ish about it. A little powdery, leather, some spices, leather. This one is a lot more leather forward on my skin, which I actually enjoy. It's a sweeter leather. It's not as punchy in the face leather as some of my other fragrances. I'm coming to learn that another one of my favorite perfumers is Natalie Lorson. She actually is the nose behind this one, and I really enjoy the fragrance. I like how she does them. I love the presentation. It kind of feels like a dial. Fragrance is any indication of what the vehicle is like. I look forward to being in that number. Next up, newer one in my collection as well, and it is another Mancera. I like what I like, what can I say? This one is Mancera Black Prestige. Ugh. Originally, I thought I was getting Gold Prestige. I'm actually glad I ended up getting this one, because this one kind of has that barbershop fougere type of feel, but with leather infused. Oh my God, the sillage on this one is enormous. It lasts forever. And it has that little bit of powdery type of situation, which I actually like. It reminds me of Serge Lutton, Cherki, and some added leather with some spices. Mm. It smells good in the air. Give me a moment, let me just pass in the ambience and all things that are beautiful about this fragrance. I love the presentation of this because it has a gold collar. I hope Mancera makes a few more with the bottles looking like this. Screw cap, solid. I love being able to pick a fragrance up out of cap if I can. I opted to get this one in the 2 ounce because I found it at a really good price. I may have paid $45 for it. With my collection growing the way it's been growing, me having anything bigger than 2 ounces is gonna take forever to get through. And then two, I don't want a fragrance to go bad. But I think started to happen with Fond de Fendi. I had it for such a while. Upon me having it for such a while, it had been around for such a while. But I don't want to be wasting my money, and I don't want to not be really utilizing my collection. So, this one is probably going to be more of a special occasion fragrance. This one is a lot more for the cooler temperatures, I feel. Next up, Versace's La Yuquam Perron. Presentation. Do you hear me? Presentation. I'm in love with that. magnetic cap, wooden box, nice bottle. This one is very leather forward. On the opening, it actually smells very much like that. I like that this one is leather forward and tones down to a fruitier leather. Raspberry, leather. It's really what I get from this one. This one is strong, like one of the freshest leather, a quality leather garment, whether it's a shoe or a bag or a jacket. Leather, leather. And then it tones down to a little more fruitier leather. Whereas ombre leather starts fruity and then merges into the leather. This one starts very leather and then it merges into the fruity. So I actually like the direction that this goes. This one is a dupe or clone, supposedly, of Tom Ford's Tuscan leather. Here's what it is. If Tuscan leather smells like this, I can rock with it. What I can't rock with is that price tag. I may have paid $60 for it. At this price point, I can't ask for anything more. The mix of projection, performance, and longevity, I'm set, to be completely honest. And I love this presentation. So, boom. Last but certainly not least, this is a fragrance that I had a sample of for a while and I enjoyed it so much. Probably about halfway through the sample and decided we get the full bottle. I've worn it during the summer and it hung in there like a champ. That is Mancera's Oud Lemon Mint. I love this one here. This is probably one of my favorite Manceras. Yes. You get lemon, you get leather, you get vanilla. There's no mint in there, but it smells so damn good. So damn sexy. So, Mancera's Oud Lemon Mint, nice presentation as well, screw cap for this one. I've seen some people have the magnetic cap. I may have an older bottle. Who knows? Who cares? This is my shit right here. That's gonna wrap up my leather list. Shout out again to Bel Air Scents for including me in this tag. I really enjoyed this one, even though it took me a while to pull it together. I appreciate the challenge. I'm actually gonna do a call to action and call a few people out and physically tag them this time, right? Right. First person I'm going to tag is Amina with Experience in Fragrances with Amina. The second individual I'm going to tag is actually Paige from Paige of Stylez. The next person that I'm going to tag is Mike from Naps and Nurture. The next individual that I'm going to tag is Melly Mel Shaves. The next individual I'm going to tag is Scent Assault, Patrick. The next individual I'm going to tag is Patrick T from Pinoy Kiwi Scent. Open tag, if you folks can hop on this leather tag channel, at me when you post your video so I can check out your list. I've been your man Uncommon Scents, and I want to thank you all for checking out my leather list. And I love you guys from the bottom of my heart to top size all the way around, and we out. Till next time.